fourth week of our big family room remodel, and today Ken is showing us how to make our new entertainment center the star of the room. In my opinion, it's already the star, but you're going to make it kind of bright, shine bright even.
You're happy with the size.
I mean,
I think we met somewhere in the middle.
We met somewhere in the middle, so everyone's
because
happy.
If he could have had his way, the entire entertainment center right. would have been the television. Well, but this is good. That's a good, size.
I love it.
So this is when all of the sort of nuts and bolts start to trim down. You can start doing the fun stuff, which is like the decorating stuff and the detail stuff. And, you know, I know you all at home have been following us and all this, and a lot of you have had questions and things at home. So I wanted to talk about things that people can do at home when they've got an entertainment center, a bookcase, something they've had for a while, and you've got that renovation fever as well, ways that you can update it and change it and make your home as fresh as possible.
Sure.
Right, and sort of really make them pop and become the star of the room.
Like, there's exactly. Really ways to do that, by
very,
the way.
Very, very easy. Very inexpensive ways.
So even if you already have one, you can apply these. Let's talk about the trim. I know the trim of ours is already built, but you've got some great ideas. You can also change your trim if you choose to.
Right. So we went with a nice, simple, clean mod, which is perfect for our transitional. But let's say, like, my mom has a built-in that she house built in 76.
Sure.
Yeah. Not so great. You can go to the trim section of any hardware store and get wood trim like this. Now, this is actually, I say wood. It's not wood. I flip it over. It's actually a pre-painted sort of extruded plastic.
Okay.
Very inexpensive. All sorts of widths and styles. And all you would do, let's say if you had just wanted a little bit of Richmond house, wanted a little bit of style, you could just come right here, a little bit of wood glue, some brad nails, and totally change the look just by running this around the outside.
I love the way that looks.
Of your house.
That is very Virginia.
If you wanted something,
that
let's
might
say,
even be even more Virginia.
To go a little bit more federal style, you could go with a little bit of detail, a little bit of detail like that.
If
you
I love that. And then this one is really fancy, but
you know,
also
we
modern.
Live in an Edwardian, so you could really get kind of Victorian tooled leather sort of look like that, and it would look like it's always there. All sorts of width. This is 3-inch, 2-inch, 1-inch. Fine. Take your measurements at home. Go to the hardware store and then have fun. All you do is cut a miter at the top and run it there. If you don't have the tools to do a miter or are comfortable, ask them for a corner block, just a square block that will go in the corner.
Yeah, that's right. They come with that so you can match it up.
Exactly.
Would you take it all the way across and all the way down?
All the way across, all the way down, and then you can even come back through for the narrows and even do a little piece of trim in there. Will completely change
really
a bookshelf
it.
That you have. It does.
It makes it look
trim
very expensive.
Trim is super.
And I know this is old school Edwardian, but somehow it looks very modern as well.
Well, as soon as you paint that glossy white, it just sort of feels like, oh, it's got,
it does
it's got Debbie Goose pimples on that one.
Maybe we should do it then. I was like, the universe telling us we should do it. Now, what about color? I know that we're going to keep ours white, and I do like it white, but a lot of times I see these built-in bookcases with pops of color, and it really makes it more of like an art piece almost.
It does. And painting your actual built-in or freestanding, it's a bit of a gamble. It's a risk. I personally think it's always safer to keep it the color of the trim.
Okay.
But what's really trendy right now and it's an easy way is to change the back panels. We usually paint it the same so it looks like a built-in.
Okay.
But let's say we painted just the back. I've got some little foam core pieces here just so that we can see.
So it matches our walls.
And painted it the same as the back of the wall. That's the Soho gray.
Okay.
All
there
of a sudden it's feeling much more light and airy and much less massive.
So that's true.
If you have a smaller room and want to open it up, do that.
That's true. Wow, that changes it quite a bit. Painting the same color as the wall. That's amazing.
Now, what I love is to do that same thing, but instead of painting it your wall color, go ahead and paint it a pop of color.
There
pick
you
one
go.
Of your accent color, have it match your pillows.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, this whole unit will just feel like zesty and much more modern and current.
And it's not that much of, like, you're not completely married to this because it's just a tiny little bit you could
That's
go back
right.
and
paint.
Honestly, if you don't want to tape off and paint the inside, you can do just what I did, paint little panels of wood or foam core and pop those right on the inside.
Keeping in mind that the big area in the middle there is going to be where the TV's going, I just want to remind anybody in case
right.
they didn't remember.
We so
that's why we're just
side.
Looking
no
at the outside.
Forgot. Don't worry, Cameron.
I'm going to make sure everybody knows.
Another very trendy thing, and this will actually be even easier than doing paint on the backside, is to do wallpaper. So you can buy a whole roll of wallpaper for like $30, and you can even buy remnants.
Oh, love the way
pop
that,
that into the back there and look at
go
that.
Ahead,
there.
Go ahead, Deb. Go ahead, Deb. Come on, Deb.
Add that trim.
Wow, that looks so
rich. It becomes
so
a completely different place. So if you want something more formal, more traditional.
That.
Or another great look, because wallpaper comes in so many options, Debbie, if you want to hold that for me, you could do even like this, which is sort of a modern wood parquet in the back. You know, you do that, and then let's say you match that with this
that.
More sort of like clean lined one,
oh, that's
then it becomes very like
shot?
Modern.
Yeah.
So everybody at home, so many options that you at home can like update your bookcases, your cabinets, what have you, without spending a ton
of
money.
It's like one of those computer programs where you just can swap and drag and drop things, but we got Ken who's doing it for us. Now, one of the things that I really do like and I think is important is to light these entertainment centers so well. With different, you got recessed lighting, you got different options, don't you?
And you can call an electrician, you can have it all hardwired, and it will cost a small fortune.
That's
true.
More than
that's true. It could.
Exactly.
It could.
But these days, there are LEDs and battery powers have opened up a whole wide range of really inexpensive options for lighting fixtures off, which you just
Yes, we found that out firsthand. We use LED strips, everybody. There's different options here, but what we did, and you don't need a lot of space, but just a half inch. So at our place at home, we just did LED strips down the inside here. We hid them. We used a remote, so it's not hardwired, and it's an even light on all the little sections of shelving, which is one option.
And does not cost much.
Yeah, no.
For here, what I'm going to suggest is puck lights. Now, this is a little package that we bought at Home Depot. You can go down the aisle. There's tons of different options. What these are, little individual lights, are about, that whole pack was about $30 at 30 if you want the electrician.
Exactly.
At least.
There's a battery power after. I'm going to put them on with a little bit of double stick tape, but you usually just put two screws up through the bottom. And because we just want to light this sort of center area, all we need to do is put three puck lights right here in the middle.
There you go.
You know, we would put these on with the screws, and then what I love about it comes with a remote control. They actually can come in colors. They can come like this one comes in like three different colors. So all you do, go on.
Wow.
And voila. For $30, you've got a $3,000 lighting job.
And I will say some of the puck lights do just have the double stick tape. If you're going to get these, it's only a few more dollars. Invest in the ones that screw in because they really legitimately look like,
they're like
the electrician came to your house.
And because they're LED, LEDs last for a very long time on battery. So you do not need to worry like you used to in the old days. It would last a month. You change it. You put these up, you're lasting years.
Ken, you've done it again.
You've done it again. Amazing. Just remind me one more time. Where's the TV going? No, I'm just kidding. We'll find out.
We're
going to
do a little tiny
time,
one right
everybody.
Here. Right
okay.
Here.
Well, we have our entertainment center, but we still need to find our fireplace look.
Yes.
Remember that, guys.
Yes, we need your help.
Go to HallmarkChannel.com. Give us your opinion on what style you think would make the best centerpiece for our family room. Is your favorite the stacked stone?
I love that one.
Oh, that looks great. The marble.
That's so
very impressive.
Or the ceramic tile. Look at that one, too.
Which is the easiest
very
one
classic.
To clean. And the easiest one to clean. Every time you share your thoughts on our website, you are going to be entered into Hallmark Channel's renovation sweepstakes for a chance to win one of our weekly prizes of $500.
Yes.
All right, fellas, or the grand prize of
$50,000.